Welcome to this video with the new enhancements included in the March 2023 update of the Denodo Platform 8.0. In this video series, we'll be covering the most important enhancements added for different Denodo servers and tools. In this specific video, we will review the support in the virtual data port for an embedded massive parallel processing engine. Let's start reviewing the enhancements of the virtual data port server. The virtual data port now embeds a customized version of Presto, which acts as a massive parallel processing engine, also called MPP. Thanks to this feature, the Denodo Optimizer provides native integration with several massive parallel processing systems to accelerate certain queries that require significant processing. The cost-based optimizer can detect if there exists operations that would benefit from using the MPP configured. Pushing of the query processing to the MPP engine will be used when the query requires the processing of large amounts of data to be done in Denodo, and that processing cannot be done in streaming mode. The optimizer decides when it is best to use the MPP on a query basis. The decision is based on the type of operation specified in the query, the view statistics, and the server configuration. The types of operations that could benefit from its use are operations that can be parallelized by the MPP, like aggregations, and operations that can be post-processed by Denodo would trigger swapping to the disk, like hash joins, group by, order by, and distinct. The embedded MPP allows exploring object storage like Amazon S3 or HDFS and creating base views over data stored in Parquet format. This will also create the corresponding tables on Presto. It also allows the query optimizer to apply new embedded MPP acceleration techniques that have been specifically designed for queries executed on environments containing data and object storage. Apart from these, it includes support for Presto administration activities such as updating partitions, statistics, and so on. It also includes support for exporting and promoting Presto tables and their associated base views in the Solution Manager. The Presto cluster is distributed as a Helm chart for Kubernetes, which will manage the necessary configurations. All the configurations are centralized in a single YAML file. The Presto cluster deployment process now includes a final step that creates a new special data source called embedded_MPP and also configures the data query optimizer to consider this Presto cluster for query acceleration. However, the script cluster.sh is still provided on top of Helm to manage transparently the encryption of all credentials supplied by the user. Now let's see a demo of the embedded MPP feature. For this demo, we have already deployed the Presto cluster and configured the embedded MPP data source. The demo is going to be in two phases. In the first phase, we will explore the newly created embedded MPP data source and how to introspect and create base views over the data in the object storage. Then we will learn about the new acceleration techniques used by Denodo to improve the performance of the queries. You can see here the data source embedded_MPP_DS located in the virtual database query_acceleration. This data source has been created automatically by the deployment script based on the configurations that have been specified. Let's quickly see the options available in the data source to explore the elements in object storage. Note that the data source does not have the connection tab because it is an embedded data source and the connection is managed by the deployment script. On the read and write tab, you can see several settings that you can find in other data sources, but there is a new section called Object Storage Configuration. This option allows you to connect to the buckets you want to explore. Here we have selected S3 as the file system and provided the Hadoop properties. We can choose the file system, either S3 or HDFS, and specify the object storage path we want to explore. For this example, we have connected three different object storages that will be accessible for introspection. Afterwards, you can go to Create Base View, and in the From Object Storage, you can expand the TP CDS /1.customer folder. Here you can introspect the data types as you do with other data sources. To create the base view, just click Create Selected. It will create the base view in Denodo, but it will also create the corresponding tables on Presto. You can see that the new base view is executed as other Denodo base views. Now let's see about different optimization techniques over a query, including the embedded MPP acceleration technique. The query has the cost optimizer and the MPP acceleration disabled, so the virtual data port is not going to use statistics or the embedded MPP data source, but still will use other optimization techniques like aggregation pushdown. We will execute the query now to check its execution. You can see that the query needs about 20 seconds to be completed. In the execution trace, we can see three branches, one going to Presto and the others going to Oracle. As you can see here, the aggregation pushdown is used. Now we can repeat the query, but enabling the cost optimizer. You can see that the query is executed faster, in almost 6 seconds. You can see that a data movement has been performed, moving the data stored in the Oracle data source to Presto, and then a full pushdown has been executed in Presto. Now we can repeat the query, but enabling the MPP acceleration. You can see only one branch, and now the query is executed even faster, in 1.7 seconds. What is happening here? We can take a look at the query. You can see that Presto has connected to Denodo and has accessed the query_acceleration virtual database, and the temp table was created in Denodo with the information stored, in this case, in the Oracle tables. So from the Presto perspective, the query is only going to be executed in Presto. Because of this, you will see only one branch, in this case, executed in the MPP Presto cluster. Finally, you can see a diagram of three different optimizations that we have applied to our query. Only using the pushdown aggregation, including also the cost optimizer, and finally using the MPP accelerator. Thanks for watching this video. If you want to learn more about the different enhancements added in the Denodo 8 March 2023 update, you can watch other videos in the series, or you can check the new features guide at the Denodo Platform 8.0 documentation.